When you're creating an integration, you'll be asked to select an integration pattern to use. Each of these different patterns helps you build a different kind of integration. The basic routing pattern lets you define a point-to-point integration. That means you'll connect a single source to a single destination, and then you'll map the data between them. The next two patterns are publication and subscription. These two work together. When you select the publication pattern, Oracle integration messaging is added as the invoke or the target. Then it's up to you to add the trigger or the source endpoint. In a publication integration, the message is passed from source to integration messaging without any data mapping. That mapping is going to happen later in any subscribing integrations. Once you've got your publication integration built, you can define one or more subscription integrations. They'll receive the messages from the publication. When you define a subscription integration, Oracle integration messaging is added as the trigger. Then you add the invoke or the target endpoint to receive the message. And finally, you map the incoming message to the outgoing format. Then there's the app-driven orchestration pattern. That's a really flexible and very powerful integration pattern. It's triggered by an event or a business object in some external system. In the editor, you have an extensive palette of tools to work with files, with data, and with variables. You can invoke multiple external systems. You can call JavaScript, business processes, and other integrations. You can use if-then and looping logic. You can write to log files and send email notifications. And whatever the design of your integration, you can also add error handling. Finally, there's the scheduled integration. A scheduled integration has the features and the flexibility of an app-driven orchestration, but it's triggered by a schedule. You might have guessed that from its name. Scheduled integrations can be used in different ways, but the most typical use case is to transfer files. A common example might be to use an FTP adapter to batch in large number of files for processing at some regular interval. As for the schedule itself, it can be a simple recurring interval every so many minutes, hours, days, or weeks. Or you can use ICAL expressions to define more complex schedules. So that's our first look at different integration patterns. One of them is going to help you meet your integration needs.